without any intention to become a prophet of discouragement or a prophet of doom, I want to say that the world and our country is becoming less and less Catholic. When I say we are becoming less and less Catholic, I say we are becoming more and more of the opposite of being Catholic. And what is the opposite of being Catholic? It is not being Protestant. It is not being a born-again Christian. It is not being a Muslim. No, that is not the opposite of being Catholic. When we understand that the meaning of Catholic means universal, and when we understand that the meaning of universal is all, for everybody, open for all, you would understand that the opposite of being Catholic is being regionalistic, is being factionalized, is being short-sighted, is being narrow-minded, is branding one another, calling one another names, calling for division rather than unity. In my Father's house, the Lord says, there are many dwelling places. The Father's house is not just a place up above. The Father's house is the heart of God. That is why in the song we say, Heart of Jesus, our heaven here below. The heart of Jesus is heaven, and the heart of Jesus is the Father's house with many dwelling places, with many rooms. What do we mean when we say the heart of Jesus has many rooms? The house of the Father has many dwelling places. It means there is a place for everybody. It means there is a place for everyone. Everyone. We tend to group one another in terms of conservative and progressive, strict and liberal, DDS, Dilawan, red, rightist. How many more divisions can we tolerate? And how many more divisions can we endure? We say Provinciano, Manileño. We say Mindanaon, Bisaya, Tagalog, Ilocano. How many more divisions shall we create? This is not the will of God for us. The will of God for us is to be Catholic, is to be for all, is to have a heart that is open for all. The heart of the Father is for all. We cannot stay devoted to the heart of Jesus and forget this basic truth that the love of God is for all. It is true that the love of God is for all, but let us not forget that that love knows how to discriminate also. That love discriminates between right and wrong. When we say we are for everybody, we do not mean that we will just tolerate wrong, or we will just accept evil, or we will just embrace sin. True love is also discriminating. As we say yes to everybody for the challenge, for the mission to love, we should also be courageous to say no to wrong things, to say no to murder, to say no to graft, to say no to lying, to say no to fake news, to say no to slander, to calumny, to blasphemy. We are all Catholics, and Catholic means universal. If only we can appreciate again the value, the power of being men and women for all, we would see that the world is going to be a better place. The heart of Jesus has a place for everyone. Let us stop the name calling. Let us stop making fun of one another. Let us stop branding one another that if you are not with me, you are bobo. If you are not with me, you're ignorant. If you're not with me, you are not caring for the country. If you're not with me, then wala kang ambag. My dear brothers and sisters, the heart of Jesus invites us to love everybody, to be Catholic. The Catholic love is being endangered by our provincialism, by our name-calling, by our branding one another, by our factionalism. Our country is being ruined by this factionalism, by this division. The heart of Jesus invites us to love as we have been loved by Him. Open your hearts to the heart of Jesus and be ready to love the DDS and the Dilawan together, to be able to love the left and the right together, to be able to love the rich and the poor together, to be able to love the murderer and the victim together, to be able to love everybody. It does not mean that we will tolerate evil. We must always be discriminating against right and against wrong. But we must love everybody with the love of the Lord. Make our hearts like unto thine. Your heart, dear Lord, is heaven here on earth. And may your love prevail over all of us so that we may truly be Catholics, men and women, sons and daughters, for everyone. Let the factionalism, let the branding, let the name-calling, let the divisions, let the curse words stop, and let the healing begin by loving like the love of Jesus. Amen.